Hi, I'm Radha Blank. I'm the writer-director of The 40-Year-Old Version, and this is my mood board. A lot of my visual inspirations for The 40-Year-Old Version come from hip-hop videos from the 90s. I feel it was a time where the culture was experimenting with its image of itself. There are videos from artists like Diggable Planets, A Tribe Called Quest, and Queen Latifah that show this hip-hop artist in a narrative that maybe they weren't depicted in before. I just feel like it was a time when the culture kind of opens itself up to dramatic narrative. Those videos were very inspirational to me. I also found myself inspired by the work of John Cassavetes, Hal Ashby, Kathleen Collins, Spike Lee, Robert Townsend, filmmakers who regarded New York as a character itself. So making sure that we had wide shots where you see different kinds of life happening in a scene. In a lot of those films, I feel like they employed real people. It needs to feel lived in, and it needs to come from a place of authenticity. One of my big influences was the photography work of Roy DeCarava, who often captured Black and brown people in black and white film. But the beauty is that he regarded his subject in a way that reflected nuance in their skin tones. You know, it wasn't simply monochromatic black and white film. It was this beautiful mid-tone and silver tones that show up in people's skin. Another one of my big influences for the 40-Year-Old Version was the photography work of Carrie Mae Weems. She's often a subject in her storytelling, depicting a black woman in contemplation, someone who is trying to get a better understanding of herself and even looking into a mirror. So you'll see a lot of mirrors show up in my film. Sometimes my reflection is blocked. Other times it's very present. And of course, Spike, I feel like he's given a lot of filmmakers of color permission to work in black and white, but also Christopher Guest, just in terms of like trying to capture something through a mockumentary lens. He's never trying to be funny. I think he's always trying to be honest. These are filmmakers and elements that inspired the film. So when it came to the costumes and wardrobe of the world of 40-Year-Old Version, I worked very closely with Sarah Williams, who was our wardrobe department head. We had this conversation about, you know, if we're shooting in black and white, that we want to make sure we are still able to create texture and tone through wardrobe. You know, you'll have several actors in a scene sitting at a table together with different shapes and patterns that might seem like they don't complement each other, but in this particular scene, in this space where the wall behind them is white, it creates this interesting texture. We talked about, you know, using texture in a weird way to create color. That became our answer to that. I worked with Valeria De Felice on production design and set design. When we sat down together for the first time, she mentioned Carrie Mae Weems. You know, she was like, I think your apartment and other parts of the world are a place to celebrate black women artists. So when we're in Archie's apartment, you see artwork of Simone Lee. There's a beautiful bust, you know, a woman with an afro that's sitting on his mantle. And then there's the photography of Delphine Fawendu. And so, you know, she was already kind of keyed into, you know, using set design to speak to the journey of the character, but also angle the camera on other black women artists. You know, the actors really do take on the characters and create them. The biggest thing for me to do is to trust them. And so when it comes to like working with Peter Kim and working with Osman, and then working with the amazing young actors who play my students, like, I can't teach anybody how to be that person. They're bringing that into the room. And my thing is, like, as a conductor, I just want all of the instruments playing in the right key, you know, but I'm not going to tell you how to play a tuba. I don't play the tuba, so how can I tell you how to play it? You know, I look at a slew of actors and then I find the person I feel best embodies the role. And then I let them, through conversations, I let them take it from there. There was never another title for this film. It was always the 40-year-old version. And I'll tell you, yes, I am appropriating Judd Apatow's title, okay? People have been appropriating culture from us for a very, very long time. I'm turning the tables. But also, just like Black women are contemplative, we have identity crisis too. I had performed it as a live show. It was called Rodimus Prime, the 40-year-old version of a live mixtape. So that was always the title. You know, I was nervous. I was like, are people gonna get it? Are people thinking I'm just solely doing an imitation of it? At the end of the day, yeah, you know, I am sending up, you know, his awesome films. And that was my mood board. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.